Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Don't Tell Mama. As a courtesy to our performers, we ask that there be no picture taking, no texting. Please turn off all your cell phones and keep the aisles clear for the performers. Thank you so much, and enjoy the show.
I'd like the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow. Got the string around my finger. What a world, what a life. I'm in love. The song that I sing like to make the ring go. Anytime I move my finger. Can't you see I'm in love? Life is a beautiful thing. As long as I hold that string, I need
afternoon to this wonderful show, Mathis and More. Before we delve into it, I'd like to introduce this wonderful band that's accompanying me this afternoon. To my left is this wonderful tenor sax, Mr. Mitch Endick. To his left, someone I've known for a long time, was very productive with my Mac-nominated CD, Mr. Chip Fabrizi, on drums. And right behind me, he's always hiding behind me, another gentleman that I've got to know, a wonderful, beautiful person. His name is international, and his name says it itself, Mr. John Miller on bass. And to my right, someone that I've known for about 7 years now, since I started singing and taking lessons, Mr. Bill Zeffro on piano. Bill is my music arranger and my band leader as well. I will be sitting on the stool for most of the show because I have an ill knee that is awaiting surgery, so I'm not going to be hopping up and down. It's not healthy for me. So at this point, I can sit on the stool and you can enjoy the show as it is. The show is called Mathis and More. And people say to me, well, Johnny Mathis, why Johnny Mathis? Well, Johnny Mathis is an acclaimed international singer. And ever since I was a young teenager, I've always loved his singing. When I was about maybe 14 or 15 years old, my siblings were listening to rock and roll, Elvis Presley, the Beatles, Connie Francis. And I was listening to Count Basie, Duke Ellington, Sarah Vaughan, Ella Fitzgerald, and Johnny Mathis. And I remember for my 14th or 15th birthday, my brother giving me my very first 33rd RPM album, Johnny's Greatest Hits. And my mom gave me my first stereo. And guess what happened to that album? I wore it out. It's somewhere in the house, probably in the basement somewhere. But Johnny Mathis's voice, his songs are romantic. They project images of tenderness and romance. His voice is lush and passionate. And I am a romantic person. And ever since I can remember, I love candlelight dinners, walks in the park, sitting in front of a fireplace with a special someone. And whenever I listen and hear his songs, he just pushes the right buttons. So that's where that's at. So for this afternoon, I'm going to sing six songs from Johnny Mathis, six of my favorite Johnny Mathis songs. I'm also going to sing two songs from my other favorite, Mr. Frank Sinatra, and two songs from Tony Bennett, and two songs from Bobby Caldwell. So why don't we just start?
Is fast asleep. You lie.
think of forgotten she. When your lonely heart has learned its lesson, you is if only he would call. In the wee small hours of the morning, that's the time you miss him most of all. That is not exclusively a Johnny Mathis song. It's an old song that's been sung by many, many singers throughout the years and made very popular, but it's also a great Johnny Mathis song. It's on a couple of his albums.
Caught in it.
song will get your blood circulating, that's for sure. Well, that's your problem, Bill. Yeah, it takes some B12 shots or something. This is probably one of my, well, they're all my favorites. Some of them will have a little tinge of more favoritism than the others. But, you know, that's how it is. When sunny gets blue, her eyes get gray and cloudy, then the rain begins to fall. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter, love is gone, so what can matter? No sweet loving man comes to call. When sunny gets blue, she breathes a sigh of sadness, like the wind that stirs the tree. Wind that sets the leaves to swaying, like some violins are playing weird and haunting melodies. People used to love to hear her laugh, see her smile. That's how she got her name. Since that sad affair, she's lost her smile, changed her style. Somehow she's not the same. But memories will fade, and pretty dreams will rise up where the other dreams fell through. Hurry, new love, hurry here to kiss away each lonely tear. An older near one sunny gets blue. Thank you. hear the sound of mandolins. You kiss me, and with your kiss the world begins. Your spring to me, all things to me, your life itself. Love me, say you do. Let me fly away with you, for my love is like the wind, and wild is the wind. This hungriness, let the wind blow through your heart, for wild is the wind. A cinematic songwriter, Dmitri Tiomkin, who's written many songs for many movies. And that was back in 1978, when they had the Academy Award for that movie as the best
58.
Song. 58, I'm sorry, 58?
I remember I went.
It's possible. I mean, yeah.
Skip school.
58, that's right, 58. Yeah, no, yeah. Anyway, so he wrote the song for that and won the Academy Award. And the two actors, I think it was Anna Magnani and Steve McQueen, won for the best actors. Johnny Mathis has recorded that song. He sings it, he recorded it. And he also sang it at the Academy Awards the following year. This next song is a song that was written by Stephen Sondheim and Julie Stein for the musical Gypsy. Small world, isn't it? children. Small world, isn't it? And fine. We could why Johnny? That's right. We could pull our resources by joining forces. You're a man who likes children. That's an important sign. Cause I love to have children. Small world, isn't it? There are so many more that I would love to sing, but time does not permit me to do that unless Sydney allows me to. I don't think he's going to.
Yeah, we have 87 more songs.
Yes, we do. We have like about 50 more songs, I think. Wow. No, I'm only kidding. Frank Sinatra. Frank Sinatra. Probably one of the most famous international singers of the world. And Frank Sinatra, it's hard to say who's my favorite, who's not. Each one has many wonderful characteristics about their singing, their songs, and everything. Frank Sinatra came from basically humble beginnings. He was born and raised in Hoboken, New Jersey, to Italian immigrant parents. And at the age of 19, he joined a group of musicians called the Hoboken. They became known as the Hoboken Four. Well, what happened was that my mom and dad, newlyweds, living in Carroll Gardens, and my mom had a cousin by the name of Johnny Page. He Americanized his name. And he was affiliated with the Hoboken Four. My mom didn't really remember what his affiliation was, but he did a lot of traveling with them to various places in Jersey and the city where they did their gigs. And one day Johnny called my mom and said, we just finished doing a gig in downtown Brooklyn. Would it be okay if we came over and you could prepare some dinner for us? Because we're tired and we're hungry. So my mom, being the beautiful lady that she was, caring and loving, she said, oh, of course, Johnny, definitely. So they came over, and then while my mom was preparing the dinner, Frank Sinatra walked into the kitchen, and he said to her, he says, oh, what you making? He says, I am starving. That smells absolutely fantastic. So she turned around and looked up at this very tall, thin, handsome young man with his big Adam's apple and his beautiful blue eyes. Lo and behold, of course, they enjoyed the dinner and came back several times after that. Frank Sinatra did not stay long with the Hoboken Four. I think he was only with them for a little over a year or so. And the reason why he left was because they were very jealous of him. Because all the young girls liked him and wanted more of him. And so they would beat him up all the time. And he said he couldn't take the beatings anymore, so he left. Good for him, because by doing that, he then became the crudest swooner of the big band era. And Bill has a little something he wants to tell you about that.
What am I going to do? You want me to tell him about? So after he sang on his own, he sang at the Rustic Cabin in Hoboken. And Harry James heard him there. So he sang with Harry James from 1939 till around January 1940. And then he got picked up by Tommy Dorsey. And mid-1941, he sat down one night with his pal Sammy Kahn and Julie Stein and Hank Santacola. And he said, I think I could be the greatest singer who ever lived if I leave Dorsey. And Sammy Kahn jumped up and said, I believe you. I believe you. And so the last I heard of him was he left the Dorsey Band in 1942, and I don't know what happened after that, but here we are.
Well, what happened after that is he became a famous international singer. He sold 250 million records worldwide. He only won 11 Grammy Awards. And the reason for that is because Grammy Awards didn't come into existence until around 1958. So his music singing career was practically half over by then. But you can imagine how many he would have gotten before that. So, wonderful. I mean, this is one of the fantastic, greatest singers in the world, in the 20th century, actually. So here are two songs, and I'm going to sing two of many, many songs that I love from Frank Sinatra. And this is the first one.
Oh, okay. Oh, one, three.
How did we know how much to discover? What chemical forces flow from lover to lover? How little we understand why touches of that tingle. That sudden explosion went to tingles intermingled. Who cares to define what chemistry this is? Who cares what your lips on mine, how ignorant bliss is? So long as you kiss me and the world around us shatters.
Maybe it'll do something for my knee, who knows? Music is the, how can I describe it? It's just, you can be as sick as you want. You sing songs and listen to the radio. That's your medication right there. You're healed instantaneously. Oh, I'm sorry, this is...
The very
thought. Oh, I'm sorry.
I'll do that again.
Yes, please do that, Mr. Bob. Get me into the mood.
I didn't do it right the first time.
The very thought of you And I forget to do the little ordinary things that everyone ought to do. I'm living in a kind of daydream. I'm happy as a queen and foolish though it may seem. How slow the moments go till I'm here to you. I see your face in every flower, your eyes in stars above. It's just the thought of you, the very thought of you, my just the thought of you, the very thought of you. Tony Bennett.
Who?
Tony Bennett. One of the Bill's pals, no. Tony Bennett, the ageless crooner. Tony turned 93 years old, August 3rd, 2019, and he is still healthy. His voice is as strong as ever. And Bill had played at a few parties where Tony was present, and they had a little conversation. Tell the audience, Bill, what you discussed with Mr. Bennett.
Do you want me to tell you what I discussed with Mr. Bennett?
Yes. So, I would hope so, because okay, that's part of that's the
okay, so he came to a party that I was playing, and he couldn't have been nicer. He came up and he hung with me, and he told me he was enjoying my playing, and he talked about working with Judy Garland and Count Basie. And I said, Mr. Bennett, I said, I'm a vocal coach and a teacher, and do you have anything I could pass on? He said, I warm up every day, whether I have a gig or not. You can take that to the bank, and that's why you can still sing.
Wow.
Do you want me to tell you this other little piece? I should tell you this other little piece. So he recommended me to somebody famous to take lessons. That didn't all work out, and after the show, if you want me to, I can tell you the rest of it. This is the part that I love. He called me about 6 weeks later. The number comes up unknown, and I answer, is this Bill? He said, yeah. I said, Bill, it's Tony Bennett. I said, Mr. Bennett, I'm a huge fan. He said, I know. He said, listen. Then he told me about it, but no artifice, just I know. Anyway, Tony Bennett. Are we going to do a Tony Bennett song now?
We're going to do two Tony Bennett songs, because, again, time does not permit me to sing many more, although I'd be here probably till next year. but two wonderful Tony Bennett songs.
A one, a two, a one, two, three.
The way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that. No, they can't take that away from me. The way you smile, I'll just be. The way you sing your tune, the way you haunt my dreams. No, they can't take that away from me. We may never, never meet again on that bumpy road to the bar. Still, I'll always keep the memory of. taking lots of fall. But even though I meet at each and every corner with nothing but disaster, I set my chin a little higher, hope a little longer, build a little stronger castle in the air. I'm thinking you'll be there. I walk a little faster. Bobby Caldwell. Now, some of you may not know who Bobby Caldwell is. I've never heard of him. I first discovered him maybe about, I say, 12, 13 years ago. I was listening to, well, it was one of my favorite jazz stations, WQXR, WBGO, it's a radio jazz station from New Jersey. I'm not plugging them because I'm a member and I give them, you know, money every year.
That was very nice of you.
Yes, I do. Well, a lot of, you know, I mean, I just, they light my fire, what can I tell you? They play such beautiful stuff. And this is where I first heard Bobby Caldwell. Some of you may remember or know that song that he did write, What You Won't Do for Love. Bobby is an American-born songwriter and singer, and recently returned back to the United States. He had absented himself for quite some time, was living in Japan and doing a lot of touring there, very successful touring. So he's back home again, being reestablished, and of course on these radio stations they announced the CD that the song comes from. So I went and you know, got it online. It's called Blue Condition. And these two songs, beautiful songs, at least I think they are, a lot of other people do too, are found on my Mac-nominated CD, All My Tomorrows. And I have a few of them with me today. For those of you who would like to purchase one or don't have it, they'll be outside after the show is over. And so here are the two Bobby Caldwell songs. This is the one moment that I thought I could never live through. But now, somehow that it's here, my dear, that foolish fear disappears. And saying goodbye seems sweet. It's plain that fate didn't want us on a one-way street. Don't worry about me. I'll get along. Forget about me. Be happy, my love. Say that our little show don't be a fool. Darling, why should we cling to some fading thing that used to be?
Thank you.
can't go on singing all night, please. But now I have to say it's that time in the evening when, or the afternoon, that we have to thank everyone who was responsible for bringing this show here today at Don't Tell Mama. Firstly, that beautiful gentleman that's sitting in the back, who I adore, Mr. Here. Sidney Meier. You too, Bill, sometimes.
I'm not as pretty as I used to be.
Well, I don't. I only know him 7 years, so he looks the same all the time. He's lost maybe a couple more hairs on his head. Lights and sound, Mr. Adam. Thank you, Adam. Job well done. Thank you. You didn't blind me. It's okay. I'm fine. To the white staff, I think we have Kaylee tonight. And of course, I'd have to say thank you to this fantastic band. Beautiful, all of them. The terrific Mitch Antigone, tenor sax. The wonderful Chip Ferrizzi. Thank you. The impeccable John Miller on bass. And this bald-headed dude over here.
Well, it comes in handy if you need to check your makeup.
Yes. I love you, Bill. You're the greatest. Bill, my music arranger and my, like his band leader, and my voice coach, Mr. Bill Zeffiro. And of course, the audience, because without an audience, you have no one to sing to. You sing to an empty room. So I thank you, all of you who did come today. From the bottom of my heart, I love you. Thank you. I know the marathon is going on, but so be it. New York is a city that's full of lots of activities, and sometimes it takes a long time to get from point A to point B. Thank you all for coming this afternoon. I can only give you love that lasts forever, and a promise to be near each time you call. And the only heart I own is yours and yours alone. That's all, that's all. I can only give you country walks in springtime, and a hand to hold when leaves begin to fall, and a heart whose burning light will warm the winter night. That's all, that's all. There are those, I am sure, who have told you give you the world for a toy, but these arms that I have to enfold you, and a love time can never destroy. If you're wondering what I'm asking in return, dear, you'll be glad to know that my demands are small. Say it's me that you adore, for now and evermore. That's all, that's all. Bye.